Well, good morning, everyone. You know, all year long, Republicans have been reaching out to Democrats on what we think are better solutions to the problems that the American people face. And whether it was the budget, whether it was the reauthorization of the Children's Health Insurance Program, or things like the stimulus bill. You know, the stimulus bill was supposed to be about jobs. Instead, it turned out more money for Jack Murtha's empty airport. This is not really what the American people expect ought to be done with their money. But Republicans are going to continue to work this year on what we think are better solutions. We're working on a better solution for health care that will maintain the doctor-patient relationship, making sure that patients can choose their own doctor and not be forced into some government-run health care program. And when it comes to the issue of energy and climate change, we can move America toward energy independence and clean up our environment. We don't have to have one or the other. And we believe that our all-of-the-above energy strategy that encourages the development of renewable sources of energy, along with nuclear energy, and yes, more American-made oil and gas, can achieve both more energy independence and to make sure that we're cleaning up our environment at the same time. And so you'll see us continue to reach out to our Democrat colleagues. We hope that they will change from what they've done for most of the year, which is their go-it-alone strategy, and actually work with us to help solve the issues the American people sent us here to solve. Jimmy.
Thank you very much, John. One of the things that all Americans are concerned about, obviously, is their health care and the ability to keep what they like in their health care. You know, if you can't afford the coverage that your family needs, and if you can't get the treatment that you need, obviously you're being denied access. And that is a crisis. And Americans believe that there is a crisis in health care. We've got to address the American health care challenges. We're working to find immediate, measurable ways to do that, and without jeopardizing choice and quality. That's what Americans want in their health care system. We must protect the doctor-patient relationship. The Democrats' one-size-fits-all program just is not being accepted by the American public. One of the things that they're concerned about is it's estimated that over 100 million Americans will lose their health care, as a result of the Democrat plan. That's not going to be accepted by the Americans who like what they have. We need to work on what's good in the healthcare system and improve it, and we need to make sure the healthcare is there. You know, whether it's a senior in Florida dealing with their cardiologist, or whether it is a pregnant mom dealing with her OBGYN, we need to preserve that doctor-patient relationship. That's what healthcare should be all about. And that's one of the major factors that Republicans are fighting for every single day in whatever healthcare reform is out there. Healthcare must be personal, and it must be tailored to the person's individual needs. And one of the things that John Boehner has entrusted a working group dealing with healthcare to do is come up with exactly that. You know, it's interesting that recently even the Blue Dogs expressed some concern about where the healthcare bill may be going in the House of Representatives. And I think that's a good sign. And we stand ready to work with the Blue Dogs to accomplish meaningful healthcare reform that puts patients first. Mike?
In addition to my duties as House Republican Conference Chairman, Leader Boehner asked me to lead the American Energy Solutions Group in the House Republican Conference. Our task is to first do no harm by doing our part to stop the national energy tax that Democrats will be unveiling this week in the form of their cap and trade legislation, and also, as the leader suggested, to develop a comprehensive energy alternative built on the all-of-the-above foundation that the Republicans unveiled in the last Congress. We look forward to doing that. We had a successful energy summit on Capitol Hill last Tuesday, and we'll be headed out on the road before the end of this month to Pittsburgh, to Indianapolis, and to a destination in California as well. But let me speak for just a second about the issue of energy. When I was home in Indiana this weekend, there is a sense among many that the economy has bottomed out and that we may be beginning to see a light at the end of the tunnel. But along with that sense of hope is a profound anxiety that this administration and Democrats in Congress will short-circuit our recovery in the next 2 years by passing a national energy tax. And this we must not do. Like millions of Americans, Republicans are anxiously awaiting the details of the cap-and-trade bill. After months of asking Democrats to reveal the numbers, it sounds like the horse trading is over. But the American people hope the Democrats haven't horse-traded away our prosperity in the cap-and-trade bill. The reality is the purpose of cap-and-trade legislation, no matter how it is deployed, the purpose of cap-and-trade legislation is to discourage consumption of CO2-intensive products, energy, and means of transportation by raising costs to consumers. It is a national energy tax, and the American people know this. It is a tax that falls most harshly on lower-income Americans, fixed-income Americans, and if I may say with some sincere regional concern, cap-and-trade legislation represents an economic declaration of war on the Midwest by liberals in Washington, D.C., and it must be opposed. Republicans will offer better solutions. We'll offer an energy alternative that's built on more domestic exploration for oil and coal and natural gas. We'll embrace an all-of-the-above strategy that embraces wind and solar and nuclear. We'll even advance clean coal technologies. But we must not allow this administration and this Congress to pass in these difficult economic times a national energy tax that will raise the cost of energy to every single American by household by thousands of dollars per year.